गुड मॉर्निंग, आई एम अमित पाटिल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम ऑटोमोबाइल डिपार्टमेंट. टुडे वी टेक अ न्यूमेरिकल फ्रॉम सब्जेक्ट मैकेनिकल वाइब्रेशन. हियर वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द नेचुरल फ्रिक्वेंसी ऑफ द सिस्टम विच इज ड्रॉन ऑन द बोर्ड. सो वी कैन सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम बाय थ्री मेथड. फर्स्ट वन इज अ न्यूटन मेथड, सेकंड वन इज द एनर्जी मेथड एंड थर्ड वन इज द रेलैग मेथड. अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन मेथड, the summation of forces and couple equal to zero. According to energy method, total energy, that is kinetic and potential energy, remain constant. And according to third method, which is Rayleigh method, total maximum kinetic energy equal to maximum potential energy. We solve this problem by second method, which is energy method. So initially the system is stationary, so we have to give the displacement, because until and unless we give the displacement, vibration doesn't occur. So we give initial displacement to the pulley, which is angular displacement. So angular displacement of pulley through angle theta. As the we give the angular displacement to pulley, the mass moved vertically downward, which is a linear moment. So linear displacement of mass, which is we indicate by value x, which is equal to r theta. Now why here come the r theta? The mass is connected to a pulley which radius is a small r, and theta is the angle through which the pulley moves. So x equal to r theta. Now we convert this displacement into velocity and acceleration, as these values are required in further problem. So velocity of mass equal to x dot r theta dot, acceleration of mass equal to x double dot equal to r theta dot. Here the kinetic energy is present in mass and pulley. Why? Because moment occur in mass, which is linear moment, and in pulley, which is angular moment. So total kinetic energy equal to kinetic energy of mass due to linear moment plus kinetic energy of pulley due to angular moment. It is indicated by 1/2 mx dot square, and angular moment is indicated by 1/2 I theta dot square. Here m is the mass, x dot is the velocity, I is the moment of inertia of the disk, which is 1/2 mr square, and theta dot is the velocity, angular velocity. X dot value r theta dot square, 1/2. Now here I is the moment of inertia of the disk, so the value of I is 1/2 m r square theta dot square. Now why we take here capital R? Because capital R is the radius of the disk. Potential energy now here, the potential energy is present in a spring. So potential energy equal to 1/2 k x1 square. What is x1? X1 is the deflection of a spring. Why deflection occur? As the angular displacement of the pulley takes place, there is a deflection in a spring. And what is the value of x1? r theta. Why we take a capital R? Because spring is connected to a pulley which radius is a capital R and theta is the angular displacement. So value of x1 come r theta square. Now according to statement of energy method, total energy remain constant. Here kinetic energy in two forms, kinetic energy due to mass moment and pulley moment. What we do in this step, we are just taking the values which we derive initially, and here we take the derivative with respect to time. Why we take the derivative with respect to time? Because here from converting displacement to velocity and velocity to acceleration, we have to take the derivative with respect to time. So we are taking derivative of this whole equation with respect to time. Now we take the common constant, which is 1/2 mr square. Now derivative of theta dot is 2 theta dot theta double dot plus, now this term 1/4 mr square. Theta dot square derivative is 2 theta dot theta double dot plus last term 1 plus k r square constant, and derivative of theta square, which is 2 theta theta dot equal to 0. Now what we do in this step, we cancel the common. 2 2 get cancel, 2 it remain 2, 2 2 get cancel, and theta dot, which is common in every term, get cancel. So what is remaining? Mr square theta double dot plus 1/2 mr square theta double dot plus k r square theta equal to 0. Now we take the common term of theta dot, so in bracket we get mr square plus mr square divided by 2 theta dot plus term kr square theta equal to 0. Now we know that to calculate the natural frequency, we have to compare this the equation, which is m theta dot plus omega n square theta equal to 0, and theta dot now this term indicate natural frequency. So by comparing this equation, we get the term mr square plus mr square by 2 theta to 0. What is natural frequency then? Omega n equal to under root of this term kr square mr square plus mr square by 2, and this is indicated by radian per second. If in the problem frequency is asked in hertz, then formula for hertz equal to omega n divided by 2 pi, which is in hertz. So kr square एम आर स्क्वायर डिवाइड बाय 2 पाई इन हर्ट्ज। इन सम प्रॉब्लम दे जस्ट आस्क यू द इक्वेशन, इन सम प्रॉब्लम द वैल्यूज ऑफ स्टिफनेस मास मास ऑफ पुली आर गिवन एंड यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू। थैंक यू।